11th, June the 5th, 10 p.m. There's been storms coming all week, really, but I wanted to show you this one where I cut it right in half. I'm right here in Houston. And I have all my equipment pointing north right now for this thing that was coming. I have it on real super slow so you can see it in slow motion. Here it comes. See this big thing? It's coming down. It's one full piece. And as soon as it starts hitting my equipment, it starts shearing. It starts spiking all the way around, turning white. And as soon as it comes close to Houston right here, it split it right in the middle. See, there's two red parts now. It split directly in the middle. As soon as it comes over Houston, right over me, right here, boom, it splits right in half. And there's two red parts. One goes that way and one goes this way. Split it right down the middle. Because these cannons that I have, these Orgone cannons, they cut this like butter. You can see it better on something that's turning like a hurricane because it disrupts it easier. You can see it easier. But it works on storms too. It just takes the red out because the storms aren't really spinning yet. And so you can see this monster coming down. See all the white around it? That's the spiking effect that means the Orgone's hitting it. It's breaking it apart. And I'm right here. I'm pointing up, two dishes up right here. Boom. And as soon as it goes over me right here, it splits into two parts. Right exactly over Houston. And that's no coincidence, folks. You think that's a coincidence that storms just don't split in half like that? Here's another angle. This is clean, long wave infrared satellite. It's on cod.edu. I'll leave the link somewhere. I'll try to leave them on here. See, it blew it apart. Boom, it's gone. Now another one's starting over here by San Antonio. But it's not coming this way. It's going south. And it's already coming apart. One more time. Here's Houston right here. Pointing up right now, I'm trying to slice it right in half, and I do. Boom, right there. Split it right in half. Down. So it comes on pretty in one solid piece, and as soon as it hits Houston, it turns into two pieces, and they both disintegrate pretty much. They turn green. Once it's green like that, it's just rain. It's not even like thunder or lightning or nothing. It's just like spring rain. That's what I try to do. I try to take the red out of it, so there ain't no chaos. This is what I do.
Stay in my shadow. Why? Just do as I say. feel that great god wrath.
Normally when a bird lands on my boat, I kill it before it can shit. What is this? You dare bring mortal to the source of creation?
He's valuable to me. I could not leave him behind.
Ah. Why have you come? I would only ask something of you. In that case, I should stop what I'm doing and heed your bidding.
Grandfather, I'm sorry. I mean, no disrespect.
I don't know the difference. Stay there. Be quiet. I have work to do. Egypt must never be destroyed by chaos. So you see, there are things worse than Seth.
You're wrong.
That demon isn't the one who murdered my father, murdered your son.
They are both my sons. They were both equal in my eyes, as is all of my creation, and the uncertainty of its destiny is my will.
So what is it actually that brings you here?
Allow me to fill my flask with these waters.
The waters are not mine.
Maps and view screens display up-to-the-minute pictures of the weather around the Earth. Every hour, reports are automatically received from all points at sea, on land, and in the air. 22,000 miles out in space, three robot satellites train their sensitive television eyes on all parts of the Earth. These pictures are monitored on viewing screens in the weather center. Here in the computing room, electronic machines digest the constant flood of information received from all stations. This is then translated into an ever-changing diagram of the Earth's weather. Forecasts for every sector of the globe are made months in advance. Prediction charts have indicated that a powerful hurricane will begin forming today in the Atlantic Ocean. The electronic weather map shows an intense storm system building up about 1,000 miles due east of Miami, Florida. The controller calls for a close-up satellite view of the troubled area.
Coco 526, Yankee 2.5.
Okay, controller, Coco 526, Yankee 2.5.
The characteristic swirling clouds of the hurricane are beginning to form. At sea, the waves anticipate the violence to come. The controller calls for a last-minute prediction of the hurricane's path. If control measures are not begun at once, the hurricane will smash across densely populated areas within 48 hours.
A hurricane is forming 960 miles east of Miami, Florida.
Control measures are ineffective. It will pass inland at Cape Hatteras in 48 hours. Control operations will begin within 2 hours, but safety precautions should be completed from Cape Fear, north no later than 6 p.m. tomorrow.
At Weather Central, the control strategy is mapped out. A ridge of high pressure slants across the eastern United States between two low-pressure storm systems. If these two storm centers are intensified, the high will build up along the coast, forming a barrier that will turn the hurricane out to sea.
Stand by. Now pulling in satellite number one for visual check of low pressure systems, L20 and L21.
The operator brings the satellite into focus on the two storms. One centered over Kansas, the other over Labrador.
Changing to northeastern low, L21.
Touch of a button, the battle begins. On the ground, chemical cloud seeders begin to work the two storm areas. Robot planes seed the clouds from above. The storm centers over Kansas and over Labrador intensify as seeding continues.
Now changing over to Hurricane Center HA.
The fury of the hurricane mounts as 100-mile-an-hour winds lash the sea to a foaming frenzy.
All stations, sector C. Activate Phase 2 Control Plan Delta. Set Vapor rockets for 42,000 feet. Execute.
As an emergency measure, the controller calls for a salvo of vapor rockets to be fired ahead of the path the hurricane is predicted to take. These artificial clouds will block the sun from evaporating more water to feed the hurricane. The reports coming into the control center indicate that the diversionary cloud seeding over Kansas is now creating a flood basin. Specially equipped robot aircraft are dispatched immediately to release a high concentration of cloud seeding material into the fringes of the storm. Heavier seeding from the ground also helps to subdue the rain by spreading it over a wider area. The controller calls for another view of the hurricane, which has now moved closer to the coast.
Signal out on number one satellite. 10-minute interruption for correction. Have you anything else in the area?
Satellite station S1 is approaching area. Make contact.
S1, this is Weather Central. Request video signal and grid coordinates, COCO.
An emergency situation has developed. In an orbiting space station 1,000 miles above the hurricane, a crewman sends a temporary picture back to Weather Central.
R5S5, thank you.
The hurricane has stopped moving toward the coast,
but is still intensifying. It must be made to move northward and out to sea. This is a crisis.
Aberdeen Station. Activate multiple seeding rockets on course 117.
The controller decides to fire cloud seeding rockets just ahead of the hurricane, hoping to start it moving.
Well, you get the idea. This is a 1959 Disney movie about weather modification. You can catch it online. It's only like 15 or 20 minutes, but they are doing some of this stuff. But really, all you need to stop a hurricane is the stuff that I have. I've stopped several of them, and I don't know. I just wanted to show you. So here's this thing being sliced in half, like raw, killing the chaos, the storm. That's a good analogy, really, because these things come every day. And in the summertime, they come every summer as hurricanes. And those things will kill you, drown you, lose your pets, your house, your car, everything. And insurance won't even pay for it. They'll say it's an act of God. So take it how you will, but I'm just trying to let you know that I figured out a way how to stop this shit. And anybody could do it. It's easy. All you have to do is point orgone at the sky. This is my latest one. I don't know if you can see it. It's on a satellite dish. It's got selenite and it's got orgone all the way around it. And it's on a turret. So I just turn the turret. Turn it in any direction. That's a big piece right there. So anyway, have a good day. I just want to show you this. I'll be back with more. Hurricane season is starting, so please watch me on my channel. Any hurricanes that show up in the Gulf or anywhere around there, watch them, because I'm going to be tracking them and I'm going to be trying to break them up, especially around Houston. So I can't really stop them anywhere else from going anywhere except Houston, because that's where I'm at. I can't guarantee anybody else, but in Houston I can guarantee hurricanes will not hit directly, probably ever again. I mean, you can just see the effect of it right here. That's just a little small example how it just sliced it right in half from right here in Houston. Boom. Thank you. Have a good one. Love you guys.